Here's an interesting question as I looked at Kenny Sutton on the bench. Scott Niedermayer comes back in the lineup for Game 7. Which defense sits? You tough to sit Kenny Sutton.
Well, he's had two splendid games, you're right.
He has.
Here's Mogilny moving in. Mogilny cruising, fed one across, and defended out of the way was Randy McKay by Berg. Rafalski hands it over to Stevens. Stevens waits, deals it back off for Gomez. It's squid back on, and we get a stoppage of play. And what have we here? We have Curtis Joseph being mugged by McKay, and I'm not sure what brought it all about. And now Joseph is jumping into a pile.
Well, he just wants a red jersey. I just saw the end of it, and Curtis Joseph flipped out. Randy McKay flipped out on Curtis Joseph. So I really don't know what caused that. Scotty Gomez trying to get Danny Markoff off of Randy McKay. But you know what? When Marty Brodeur was ran over by Darcy Tucker, I wonder if the Devils maybe didn't think there had to be some sort of payback. I mean, that's the jungle mentality. And I don't want to insinuate anything as McKay with his helmet off finally gets loose. But I don't know, because I just saw Randy McKay going bananas on Curtis Joseph at the end of the infraction.
Yeah. Joseph is really beside himself, and Dan Marowelli and Ray Scapanello having to talk to him. 25.9 to go.
Well, both teams trying to develop a rallying cry for the next game, and it's involved both goaltenders. And I'm not quite sure now who Curtis Joseph wants to get at. It was obviously McKay that he was involved with. But Randy McKay with a very important goal. Gets the early shower himself. Interesting to see if Curtis Joseph gets tossed for entering late.
I'm with you. I looked down and play was starting to go the other direction. I looked down and I saw McKay going all over Joseph. But I have no idea what was happening prior to that, if anything. McKay was one of the more irate when Darcy Tucker put his knee into Brodeur.
Well, let's have a look here now. Let's watch the goaltender area. Now, there in front, it's McKay. Okay, nothing too much yet. Whoa. Now, Randy usually is more poised. I'd like to see that one again. And there you see Joseph dropping the paraphernalia and grabbing whoever's closest. Now, let's see what happens here.
How he wound up down.
Oh, there it is. There was a first chop. That one hurt Randy McKay. Because it just wasn't that last push. That was not the one that set off Randy McKay. Now watch the stick of Cujo, right coming up here. There's the chop in the back of the leg knocking down McKay. And there's a push, that wasn't much. Still not a whole lot. Maybe the butt end of Joseph swung around and clipped Randy McKay. Because usually Randy's pretty good with goaltenders. It takes something extra to set him off. And Curtis Joseph obviously found that button. But no injuries. Everybody seems to be fine. And we're just going to have a little more emotion and drama and carryover for Game 7. 25.9 seconds left. I think Curtis Joseph needed something to get the adrenaline back up. He didn't play the game he would have liked to with that early goal against Sikora from just inside the blue line. And then he struggled and battled, but wasn't able to play the game, or at least the level that he had hoped. So he goes over to the bench, and is he gone or just looking for some H2O, get the temperature under control? Actually, Curtis Joseph got ran over by Danny Markoff, who was trying to come in and help him.
So that was the reason that one of the replays we saw, he was already down on the ice in his goal crease.
Yeah, I think so, Doc, although I'm not sure if that happened before or after. But you're right, yeah, he was down early at one time, wasn't he?
Noticed that, yeah, and I thought, well, maybe there was some reason he'd gone down. Let's take a look again.
Yeah, Gomez is going to go through the crease here. See this, down low.
may have already happened.
Yeah. Yeah, he's already chopped Joseph. Yeah. I mean, Joseph has already chopped McKay. And then the elbows and the feet become involved.
He's just going after anybody in red. Now, I noticed he had gotten back up at one point. I think that was before this. Yeah, he was back before that. But then he and McKay get involved, and then a crowd gathers. And McKay has is one that we know is gone, but we don't know for what.
Well, the other thing that's going on here now, just like if you're the guy on deck, and you're on deck, and the guy in front of you gets beaned. Let's see. Here's the play off the rush. Let's see what happens. Here's the play. Okay, Curtis Joseph, that's the one I saw, Doc.
Yeah,
he just went
fell.
Down to the ice.
Okay, very good. Thanks,
but what
guys.
I'm saying is, if you're the next batter on the other team after your last batter has had a beanball thrown at him, you're kind of a little sensitive. And I think Curtis Joseph was thinking, okay, we just ran over Brodeur. Who's coming my way? And so he's looking for something. McKay's looking for something to maybe give a little payback to Joseph after Brodeur was kneed to the head.
See, before the playoffs started, one of the areas of not emphasis but continuation for the playoffs was going to be the crease area.
That's right.
And we've seen a lot of infractions that have involved goaltenders that haven't been called, which has struck us as odd. I have a feeling they're going to be very tight on it in Game 7.
Yes, and they should.
Well, sure. I mean, especially if you say you're going to do it.
Yeah.
Then you should. Otherwise, your words don't mean as much. Well, anyway, 14.6 to go in the third. The Devils still have a power play on. They have a two-goal lead and have sufficiently forced a seventh game that will be played two nights from now back in New Jersey. Now, we will try to get you all of those penalties just so that you have an idea on what was assessed here near the end. Stevens gets two for roughing. McKay, two for interference, two for roughing. Joseph, two for roughing, two for leaving the crease. And that was what was handed out. Well, it'll take a seventh game. A rather bombastic finish to this, but a decisively strong game by the New Jersey Devils and their goalkeeper, Martin Brodeur, tonight. Setting the stage for a Game 7 between these two teams that will be played back at the Meadowlands in two nights. The Devils had a 2-1 lead in the series. Toronto had a 3-2 lead in the series. The Devils have evened it up at three games apiece. You want to hear from these guys, from their coach and all of that? Just tons coming up. You'll get your chance beginning after these words.